What's poppin', everybody? Welcome to episode 3 of The Mental Game, a part of the CHN Network. Today I have a really special guest with me, the co-founder himself, Josh Hammer. I'm really excited. We're going to talk about confidence, and I can't wait to get started. Let's get to it. Here with the co-founder of CHN, Josh Hammer. Really appreciate you being on today. I wanted to talk to you about confidence and how your unique story that you are going to talk about right here, how that kind of affected your overall confidence, just for you as a person in sports, outside of sports, and just kind of talk about your unique story.
Sure, I'd be happy to, and thanks for having me. I'd give you a big hug, but obviously we have to practice social distancing. So, but yeah, as you can tell, JJ and I have been longtime friends since 2012 at Holy Names University. And I would say we both have always had this like really profound respect because of the sports that we, you know, you were killing in basketball and I was figuring it out in baseball. So
he's a stud.
Oh, I don't know about that. Thank you. See, and that's what we need to talk about, confidence, confidence. And so, I'm happy to use this platform to share a little bit about my story and with baseball, but it also really relates to what I do off the field as well. Mm-hmm. I guess to start it, it was all about my weight. I used to be pretty overweight. I wasn't always, you know, the strongest guy. I wasn't the fastest guy. Mm-hmm. I wasn't the hardest thrower. And so there's often a lot of times where I felt really insecure. Because, you know, I didn't have the most velocity on my fastball.
Yeah.
I just didn't feel good enough.
Yeah.
And so as time progressed, I kind of learned what I needed to do to find a way to take my game to the next level. And if taking my game the next level meant that I have to start having extreme ownership and taking ownership of like who I am as a ball player, my, you know, my skills, my gifts, my talents, but also my weaknesses.
Yeah.
And I would dwell on my weaknesses so much that that would end up with a poor result. Mm-hmm. I still hung in there. I would battle through, take it pitch by pitch, but having being overweight, insecure, not really feeling good enough, always really set me back as a person. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't feel like I'd be good enough in the classroom. I didn't feel like I'd be good enough on the ball field. And ultimately, it's just a really dark space to be in and it gave me a lot of anxiety.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like for a lot of people, we dwell on our weaknesses so much and things that we're not good at instead of focusing on a lot of things that we're really good at. And obviously, there's always going to be people that are going to be like, oh, you're so good at this, you're so good at that.
Yeah.
And we might say thank you, but we don't think about that. We always think about so many negative things. Just it's human nature, you know what I mean? It also just goes to show that you were able to play college ball. You were able to get your weight to where you wanted it to be, and I'm just assuming that that helped your overall confidence in other areas besides baseball, because like I was telling you guys, he was really good at baseball. The fact that he got to play college baseball is a blessing. A lot of people, they would love to be in that position, and I think it just shows that you were willing to put the work in, put the time in, and also have just enough confidence to get yourself there, and obviously it was something that we all need to work on. It's just once we're in that position, working on how I'm gonna put myself over the top and kind of instill more confidence in myself.
I would say to your point, like one of the biggest things that really helped me was my coaches would keep it real with me. Mm-hmm. And I think any mentor, educator, it's always good to keep it real with your students and let them know, hey, you know what? This isn't your strong suit. We could work on that. Mm-hmm. But I really believe in what you're doing and what you're bringing to the table. I always say there's three things that we can all control. Mm-hmm. Attitude, energy, and focus. Mm-hmm. If we can control those three things and put our heart and soul into it, I think that's how you really grow. And when you surround yourself with good teammates and people that aren't toxic around you, that was like the formula essentially that helped me take my game to the next level.
Yeah.
And my leadership on the team. When it comes to being a Division II student athlete, there's so many stigmas, you know, around that. And so I would say what seems to work for me, or worked for me as a ball player, was understanding that, yeah, guess what? I don't throw the hardest. Mm-hmm. I don't. I'm not the fastest guy out there. I don't lift the most weight. But what can I control? Mm-hmm. I can control throwing strikes. I can control how I deliver the ball. And I can control on just bringing my A game to practice and taking that rookie mindset and being and learning how to grow in my own confidence.
Yeah, and I think that's important because you talked about energy, attitude, and I think that effort is a big thing because a lot of people, when you get to, if whether you were a freshman and you're trying to make JV, once you get on JV, some people get complacent. They're like, okay, I finally made it. And then if you want to make varsity, if you're on JV, you get on varsity, like, okay, I did it, whatever. And then some people get complacent, and then that's kind of what separates people. Yeah. And so that's what I was saying as far as it's impressive that you were able to get your weight down to where you wanted to be and to work on your game because you were able and fortunate enough to play college baseball. A lot of people don't have that.
Yeah.
Not because they aren't gifted enough, but because they don't want to put in the effort, the time.
That's it right there.
And so I think that for me, something that I always like to relate to people who, whether it's in sports, in a classroom, in your own craft, whatever the case is, putting that effort and that time in, if you put enough in, you should bet on yourself.
Yeah.
And I think that that's something that a lot of people don't understand. If you're, for me, for instance, like when I would work out when I was younger versus when I work out in college are two completely different
just
things.
A whole different,
coach,
yeah.
My coach used to always get mad at me because I would try to go hang out with my friends after school instead of going to the gym. And I'm just like, okay, I need a social life. And obviously, I was making excuses.
Yeah.
Like, to be honest with you. And so when I got to college and we weren't that good compared to in high school, we were losing 5 games max in the season. And so I think for me, it was just like, okay, I really, really, really need to work a lot harder than what I'm doing.
Yeah.
And I think that once I started to figure that out, I think that my confidence started to grow, but it still wasn't where it needed to be. And I think that if I could change anything, it would just be my mindset and how I go into each and every game, into every practice. If I work on this specific move, this specific shot every single day, there's no reason for me to doubt myself.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And I think that that's something that I would hope that a lot of people can think about, whether it's in, like I said, a classroom, whether you're a CEO, whether you're starting your own clothing brand, whether you're a ball player, it doesn't matter.
Right.
If you do something to the best of your ability every single day and you go as hard as you can, you just have to live with the results. Most of the time, the results are going to reward you.
Exactly. And to that point, you know, in high school, I was really blessed to have some awesome coaches that really kind of installed that belief in me that, hey, you know what, Hammer, you won't be a Division I guy. If you do, you'll be able to redshirt, maybe make the team.
Mm-hmm.
But you can go to D3. You can go to NAIA. And if you want to reach for the stars, go for a D2. Mm-hmm. Did that hurt to hear that? Actually, no. I would say most student athletes, it was like, oh man, I'm not a D1 guy. Mm-hmm. But I was lucky to be around the game for so long too, that I at least had that like reality check.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that was what was helpful for me though. It's important to have hard conversations with yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I've already did that maintenance work, you know, my junior and sophomore year of high school. So that was kind of what kind of set me apart senior year was like, all right, I guess I know what I'm striving for, but I have a dream to go D1, of course.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, finances, that's the other thing. You got to find a school that's best fit for you.
Yeah.
And that goes for jobs. It goes for whatever. If you're passionate about it, you got to follow your bliss because that's how doors are going to open.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to be passionate about it and you got to put in the work.
That's all the time we got today for episode 3 of The Mental Game. I really want to thank my special guest, Josh Hammer, the co-founder of the CHN Network. Make sure you guys go like and subscribe on the Costin & Hammer YouTube channel. And make sure you guys stay healthy, stay safe, wear a mask. God bless.